Integrated graphics have come a long way over the years. From the NVIDIA Inforce IGPs of the early 2000s, to the debut of the AMD APU in 2011, to Intel's current Meteor Lake laptops with ARC graphics on board, the lowly IGP has only grown in performance and relevance. Today, though, we're looking at an innovation in onboard graphics before any of those, one that few remember and even fewer still talk about today. This is the AIMM. AIMM, or AGP Inline Memory Module, is exactly what it sounds like, a stick of RAM for your AGP slot. To explain why it exists in the first place, we have to go back to 1998. That was the year Intel entered the 3D graphics market with their i740, a GPU with a fascinating and troubled history that really deserves its own video. The i740 was designed to make full use of Intel's AGP standard, to the point where textures would be stored in system RAM and shuffled across the AGP bus when needed. To make a long story short, it didn't do nearly as well as Intel hoped. It wasn't a bad performer at launch, but between driver issues early on and unrelenting competition throughout the rest of the year, it never had a chance. Fast forward to April of 1999, and Intel was ready to try again with an improved successor, the i752. This new chip would have DirectX 6 multi-texturing, anisotropic filtering, and 50% higher clock speeds than the i740. But against existing cards like the Riva TNT 2, Rage 128, and Voodoo 3, it would have been an even bigger egg on Intel's face than the i740 was. The i752 never made it to mass production, and the i754 that would have followed it was never produced at all. It wasn't a complete waste of time, though, because the i752 would be built into the 810 family of chipsets for budget PCs, making it Intel's first platform with integrated graphics. One variant of the chipset, the 810DC100, even allowed motherboard manufacturers to solder 4 MB of display cache onto their boards to offload the Z buffer from system RAM, improving 3D performance by alleviating some of the pressure on 810's already limited memory bandwidth. When Intel launched the improved 815 chipset family in June of 2000 using the would-be i754 core, display cache returned as the AIMM, though Intel also called it GPA, Graphics Performance Accelerator. This was the first and only time end users had the option to add dedicated RAM to chipset integrated graphics. Every AIMM has the same specs: 4 MB capacity, 133 MHz SDRAM, 32-bit wide. I wasn't able to find any info on pricing in the US, but these articles from PC Watch in Japan show a sale price of roughly 3,000 yen in September 2000, or a bit under $30 not adjusted for inflation. Their testing showed a substantial 30% improvement in 3DMark 2000, and in a market where a 32 MB GeForce 2MX would have set you back the equivalent of $120, that could have been a tempting prospect. Before we get into performance testing, it's worth going over the capabilities of the 815 family's graphics core to get a general idea of what it can do. We're dealing with a DirectX 6 and OpenGL 1.1 accelerator, with a single pixel pipeline and TMU, and no 32-bit color support. The core is clocked at 133 MHz, and both it and the CPU share 1066 MB a second of memory bandwidth from the system RAM. With the AIMM, it gets another 533 MB per second all to itself. Unlike most other onboard graphics at the time, i815 relies on its driver to dynamically allocate up to 32 MB of system RAM. For the test system, we have a small form factor Dell Optiplex GX150 donated by my good friend Sedriskin. Without him, this video wouldn't exist. It packs a 1 GHz Coppermine Pentium III, a 512 MB stick of PC133, and Windows XP RTM with all unnecessary services disabled to keep background CPU load down. I'm using the latest graphics drivers hosted at the RetroWeb, but sadly they offer no settings for anything 3D. That sucks, because VSync appears to be forced on in most tests, and in one instance it really messes with the results. PowerStrip was no help. It can force higher refresh rates, but doing so reduced performance, so I didn't bother. One final note before we start, I tested both stock and tuned memory timings using the memset settings on screen now. I did this to get a sense of whether i815 is more bandwidth or latency sensitive, and to gauge whether the AIMM as a hardware upgrade can outperform tweaks you can do for free. Now, to the benchmarks. Up first are the 3D marks, and things are off to a bad start with 99 max. RAM tuning is more effective than the AIMM here, but even with both in play, the score improves by less than 18%. 3DMark 2000 is a different story, with nearly a 35% improvement from the slowest to fastest score. The AIMM alone doesn't offer the 30% jump PC Watch measured, but it's a step in the right direction. The AIMM manages to overtake RAM tuning in 2001 SE, but keep in mind that i815 is incapable of running this one at default settings. The first actual game in the suite is Porsche Unleashed on Monte Carlo, and the AIMM knocks it out of the park with a huge 38% uplift with stock RAM. This is the result I mentioned earlier that's heavily impacted by VSync. The game has a triple buffer option that doesn't seem to work, so the double buffered 75Hz output is throwing off the results. Still, it's clear the AIMM is very effective in this one. Next is Tribes 2, an OpenGL game where I can't tell if VSync is enabled or not. Regardless, 20-30% gains are sorely needed. Fun fact, this game uses the original version of the Torque game engine that would go on to power BeamNG Drive. Max Payne's ending cutscene is brutal no matter the configuration. With just 12% between slowest and fastest, we're likely seeing fill rate limitations here. Empire Earth sees some solid 16-35% jumps in the custom Battle for the Hill cutscene, but at sub-cinematic frame rates, it's not a game I'd want to play on this system. Serious Sam SE really doesn't like IE15. OpenGL has mipmap corruption issues, and Direct3D is even slower than what you see in the graph. It's another small win for tuned RAM, at plus 13% versus 11. Dungeon Siege improves nicely with the AIMM. 23% with stock RAM, and 16% with tuned RAM. I left out the minimums for this one because DS Benchmark has a long pause here in every run. GTA 3 is absolutely terrible on this machine, but plus 14% with the AIMM is better than nothing. Mobile Forces, an Unreal Engine 1 game, responds very well to both the AIMM and RAM tuning, but the minimums are a little better with the AIMM. It's a similar story in the IdTech 3-powered Soldier of Fortune 2, with 19-32% gains offering a noticeable difference from baseline. I saved the best for last. Warcraft 3 soaked up every last drop of performance I could give it. With nearly 30-50% improvement from stock, this is the most impressive showing in the suite, playability notwithstanding. Across all 13 tests, the AIMM pulled out a slight win over RAM tuning, at plus 20% versus 18%, with both together averaging 31% faster than neither. I am of two minds about these results. On one hand, the AIMM absolutely proves its worth by living up to Intel's up to 30% faster claims, and on IGP of this caliber, every little bit helps. On the other, I think I'm more impressed by just how much a few tweaks to RAM settings can do. 5 of the 13 tests benefited more from tuning the RAM than adding the AIMM, and you wouldn't have had to spend anything to see that difference. As a concept, the AIMM succeeds. As a product, it's harder to justify. Sure, it was reasonably cheap, but i815 with an AIMM is still a far cry from older discrete cards like the Riva TNT or Rage 128. Tiger Direct was selling 16MB Vantas in October 2000 for $60, and that would have blown the doors off i815. I feel like Intel could have done more with the AIMM, even within the limits of the 815 chipset. Imagine a premium, double-sided AIMM with 8 or 16 megabytes, using the full 1066 megabyte per second bandwidth the AGP4X provides. With a setup like that, the AIMM could function like the i740's VRAM did, where textures would be stored in system RAM, and everything else goes to the AIMM. Or how about a second-generation AIMM using DDR to be paired with Extreme Graphics? These ideas probably don't make any business sense, but they're the kind of thought experiments that keep me up at night. When all is said and done, I'm glad the AIMM exists. It's a reminder that once upon a time, Intel cared about innovating in desktop graphics. These days, you only get a new IGP from them every 4 generations. The AIMM may not be anything more than a novelty today, but there's nothing else like it.